I welcome you to the guide of killing every single sort of dungeon boss with absolute ease, with the greatest of ease. There we go, that sounds slightly better. Before talking about his moves and everything, I want to say that in this video I won't be going in much detail when it comes to choosing party members, except about two bosses. But everyone else, you can pretty much choose whatever you like. And yet, an ideal party which should do in almost every situation is two dark mages, a single healer, and two knights. That should be able to do with almost everything.
We talk about Julius, he's such an easy kill that you can kill him with everything.
And because he is such an easy kill, when it comes to armor and weaponry, it really doesn't matter. Choose the best you have, and some boosting items. But the hero blood, once again, it really isn't that necessary, but I'll explain why it could be useful in a minute.
Okay, we got him.
Beginning with his one and only attack, Fatigue. Let's just show it first. Okay. So, the only effect of that move is that it has a chance to confuse you. And as I said, you really don't need anything specific to kill the first guy. But if you truly struggle with him, just give your party members some hero blood, makes them completely immune, and then just auto-bottom beat down. Yeah, this video is really not gonna take that long now, is it?
No, Alexandria, I wanted to explain her weaknesses and everything and moves. Okay.
So, time to explain Alexandria, and her only move is Double Strike. It has absolutely zero effects. She has no specific weaknesses, and she has no specific powers. The only thing her move does is, let me show you, I guess, wait.
Let's hope she uses it eventually. Double Strike, there we go. The only thing it does is, it just hits the targets. I really don't have anything, sorry, say except.
Use whatever party you like, with whatever armor you like. But if you really struggle, just give your
patrons some purple slime or ice gems. And if you really, I don't know how you struggle. It should be a piece of cake.
Okay, now we're getting to the bosses which are still completely easy and a piece of cake, but someone might struggle with them the first try.
Wait! Yes, thank you. Wait, stop, stop. Oh, thank you.
Alright, well, we got the gun and his move, careful of whatever is the name of that, you saw it yourselves. But yeah, the only thing this does is that it has a high chance to inflict random status effects, and it does a little tiny bit of damage. So equip your patrons with hero blood and beat the hell out of him. And that's about it. Once again, busy cake. We need nothing specific. It's time we talk about the best boss in the game. That being Garrick. And I actually do have a couple things to say for him. First things first, his move. And oh, he's not confused. Okay, he has an AoE attack called Quake, which I really hope he's gonna use eventually. I really do hope so. Thank you. It's just an AoE attack. It has no special effects or anything, just does damage to every single party member. His other attack, however, his other ability or skill activates only once he gets under a certain amount of HP. I think it was about 2k or under 2k. We're going to figure it out just in a second, as long as he gets slightly lucky with this. There we go. I figured it out. If he gets under 400,000 health, he starts spamming reform. In other words, get him under 4,000 health and you win. It's honestly that simple. When it comes to weaknesses, I guess you can just go on ahead and burn him or poison him. Which leads me to the next part of how to easily kill Garrick. That being the weapon. Because he is weak to fire and poison, and by weak I mean if he is fired or poisoned, he's going to take 500 damage for each, so if you can do both then just perfect. But you can burn him with this little item over here.
It has 50% chance to either burn him or put him to sleep, and people in bosses can't go to sleep, so you pretty much can only burn him with the drone.
And when it comes to poison, you can use the Dark Mage's Noxin ability.
Also, I want to say that the drone is really not necessary to beat Garrick, but it would be cool. It would make your life easier. And it can be found by randomly, and can be found between levels 300 and 400. At least the drone at level 1.
We're going to talk about level 2 when we get a little later in the video. Getting you to the next boss, who actually requires a little tiny bit of thinking in order to defeat, we have the Mora. And I will just go ahead and spam defense so I can demonstrate her rise from the grave.
I think it's pretty self-evident. I think it's pretty self-evident what that really does.
And the unique thing about her is the fact that you can damage her only using white-based attacks.
So, for example, here I can actually kill her using my Dark Mage, but that's simply just because I'm in Dimension W and I am a god.
But normally you would have to use the healer's healing abilities to kill her, or the knights. These are the only two members, these are the only two patrons that can actually kill the Mora.
When we talk about the skeletons, absolutely everything can kill them, including the healing abilities.
And that's actually pretty much everything there is about her. She can't really do anything, so as long as you have some white-based attacks, you can easily butcher her. But when it comes to a party, I honestly believe that a party of healers is going to deal just perfectly fine. If you want, you can add a knight, or you can just have a full knight party, but a party of healers is going to do the work.
If you do have some drones, you can use them to put her skeletons to sleep, and afterwards she's absolutely worthless. Just go ahead and spam her to death.
That's about it. Also, if you do kill the skeletons, she is going to respawn them. Want to say that too. But let's just finish our offense and go ahead. Yeah. Cool enough. It's going to be slightly more difficult for you. Getting to the next boss, whose ability is actually much better than I originally thought, might scare you a little bit, but in the end you see why it really doesn't matter. There we go. And I just have to hope that he's eventually going to use it.
Betcha. Amazing. And this ability actually halves the health of your patrons, which does sound incredible. But there's only one problem with it. If you have a full party of 5 members, also, it really doesn't matter what party you choose, just whatever it is, you can kill him with soul junkies if you like.
You can kill him a lot faster than he can actually kill you. But if you do struggle by some kind of miracle, I would recommend 3 specific items, and you can honestly do it using only one of them, but if you're really struggling, just get all 3. Those 3 items being the Dronen.
Simply just because Binary struggles with the same problem that Garrick does, which is he hates burn to death. Which means that just burn him and it's gonna make my and your life much easier.
Also, poison as well, so Dark Mages also work. Also, you can go on ahead and get yourself some Dragon Blood, which is a very cool item that is found between levels 300 and 400.
I said 3 items, but these are actually the only 2 I have in mind. So my bad.
And now you see one of the best abilities in the game, which can get rid of your whole party, if you're not careful enough, obviously. That this guy, Dengen, can clear whatever party I have, with whatever members, with whatever armor, with the exception of fighters, using... I do not remember the name of the move, so... Oh, you're not going to use it. Oh, I see. Well, this is his other move, Fury Chop, which, as you saw, just gets my attack down and it does little AoE damage to everyone in the party. But his other move, which I guess he's not going to show because I'm in the W dimension. But when you get to dimension 7, he will cleanse your whole party. Unless the fighters, as I've already said multiple times. But yeah, when it comes to him, just get a full party of fighters. You're going to literally obliterate him. And I don't even need to talk about the fact that there is the fighting relic, which you can level up even a little bit, and it's going to make your life even easier. Getting to the 8th boss, which at this point you really should be able to absolutely obliterate if you're using your relics whatsoever, and I'm not giving tips on the relics in this video, simply just because I truly feel
like you can just go without them if you actually want to challenge yourself a little bit. And if you do use them, in whatever way you use them, you're going to win. But regardless of that, talking about Capsicum.
Questionable concoction. The very cool thing about this ability, as you saw, is that it did zero. If you're wondering why, that's simply just because my patrons have the hero blood on them. And that completely protects them from all status debuffs. And Chaotica's ability does absolutely nothing if your patrons have any item on them which makes them immune to status effects. And I'm actually going to talk about a few of the items that actually do that in a second. And there we go, this is pretty much the only item you would need to go ahead and get rid of Chaotica easily. And it is an item which you can get from level 41 to level 60.
Another item which you do need to grind a little bit for, which also grants you complete immunity over status effects, is
the Dragon Shield.
But in order to get it, you need to grind from levels
300 to 400. And I feel like these two items should really do the job. I actually am pretty sure that these are the only two items which grant complete status effects. Complete status effects immunity. I could be wrong, okay, tell me in the description. But now we're getting to the very powerful Beerus. And his abilities always send a chill down my spine. His abilities are super simple. First one, Ice Tomb. And he actually shares this ability with the mini boss at level, I think it was about 80. And if you're wondering what it does except AoE damage, nothing! It does absolutely nothing. You have nothing to worry about. You don't need any special equipment or anything else. His other ability though is slightly more intriguing. And it's really not that big of a deal, but still, it is cool and I really hope that he's going to show it eventually. Oh well, how well can we actually get him? Oh. Oh really? You're not going to be using your ability? Please! Please make my life slightly easier and use your crystallizing ability.
Okay, let me just spam the shields until he actually uses. There we go. Thank you. And reduce damage. That's the only thing it does. It just makes him slightly tankier.
And as you saw in this situation, you can kill him before he even gets the opportunity to use it. So, once again, you need nothing special. If anything, just use the drone to burn him or the dark mage to poison him. That's going to make his life even more difficult.
Talking about burn and poison, I actually forgot to mention that Chaotica also does have a weakness for poison and burning, so go on ahead and do that to her as well if you are actually struggling.
Regardless though, it's time we talk about the boss with the most attacks in the game, who I have always been able to kill with ease. Another thing I can mention in case you are really struggling is the fact that you can get the Dronen level 2 at levels 800 to levels 1900. In other words, you can use the Dronen level 2 against Ornus and Beerus if you really feel like grinding for it. Okay, wait a second, because I actually do have to read everything from this guy because he attacks. First, I'm going to go over the obvious stuff. He is weak to fire, so Dronen it is. Level 2 if you are actually struggling with him. Just go on ahead and get yourself some Hero Blood or Dragon Shields. Oh yeah, right. Now about the abilities of Ornus. Crystallize, Fury Chop, Fatigue, Double Strike, Bit Shift, Questionable Concoction. Wow, it actually wasn't as much as I thought. As long as you do the things I said before, reading every single of his abilities, you're not struggling against him one bit. Special thanks to Sids who actually wanted me to make this video. There I forget that I'm supposed to kill the last one too. There we go, now wipe. Now, wipe is just a deal. If I had just said that sentence, wipe would have